moment. I'm crying here, okay? Because you know, it's just so great to, you know, see something great happen to somebody. I'm sorry, I know I'm gonna make you cry. I am here with Renee, and Renee, tell me a little bit about how you actually won the car. I know you have a beautiful man standing by your side, and tell me a little bit about that.
Well, Red, we call him Red, his name is Marcel. He wrote a letter to Oprah in regards to things that I do in the community and the kids I've taken into my home and the different projects I've done. And she read the letter, and it was a great letter. I wish we would have brought it. And so that got us brought to the show. I had no knowledge whatsoever of anything. I just know he called me at work, and he was like, what are you doing with? And I'm like, well, I have to go to court that day. He's like, well, no, I think you'd rather go to the Oprah show. And I'm like, get out of here, quick man. And he was like, no, serious. I'm like, you're lying. He's like, no, seriously. So I ran to my boss's office. I said, I won't be here. I won't be going to court. I got to go to Oprah. So we got there. We knew nothing. You know, we just thought we was going to be in the audience. Then we started seeing all those people coming out with those bags of stuff. And it's like, we missed the favorite show. It just so happened. Show as well.
Renee, what does this mean to you? What does this mean to you?
It means a lot to me because I've never really had anybody give me. I'm always giving for somebody who don't know me to give me something. That was, it was amazing. It's still amazing. It's like unbelievable. So I'm trying to deal with it because you're going to make me cry.
I'm
seriously.
Sorry.
But it's a great experience. It's literally unbelievable. It's like I'm in a cloud still.
And you said you wrote a letter to Oprah too, right?
No. Oh, I did. Yeah, I wrote Oprah a letter and thanked her for everything, you know, and I told her just what I said. I said, you don't know me. You've never seen me. You've never had a conversation with me. You don't know the things I do for you to do something for me. That's a big blessing. And I told her, I'm not going to stop giving because, you know, so... Yeah.
Now, I'm looking at your car pulling up here, and what color Volkswagen Beetle did you pick?
Red!
Red for Red. Now I'm talking to Red. Okay, now tell me, you kind of nominated her, right?
Kind of, sort of.
Yeah. Tell me about it.
It was simple. Like I've said since the beginning, anybody could have wrote that letter about Renee. Everybody knows about the stuff that she does in the community. Now, I'll take a little credit for writing the letter, but at the same time, anybody could have wrote that letter. I'm just pretty much along for the ride.
And you get a car because you nominated her, and she gets a car. And what color is your car?
Silver. The funny thing is, the silver is her bad luck color, and red is my bad luck. So we don't have to worry about driving each other's cars.
You know how sweet those two cars are going to look in the driveway together?
Pretty sweet.
Hey, I wanted to talk to Kelly. You are the third winner. Now, tell me how this all came about for you. It was kind of a goodness kind of show, right?
Yes, it was. And I'm kind of on the flip side of Renee. I wrote in about my uncle, who had a nonprofit organization in Detroit where he fixes up and cleans up houses down there. And he started a community center, and he's been doing it for over 20 years. Same thing. Gives, never sleeps, 24/7. And wrote in about him. There was an entry about, do you know of any heroes online? And wrote that in last September, and then got a response back in November, tickets for the show. So, and again, not knowing it was favorite thing. So,
and you know, I talked to your mom, or heard her talk a couple minutes ago. This really means a lot to you, this getting this card. You picked the silver one too, right?
Yes, good silver color. And my uncle picked red, which I see.
And I'm originally from Detroit.
And you're from Detroit?
Yes.
What a tie-in. It's like something's...
Yeah.
And I'm from Detroit, so that's amazing. Oh. Tell me what this means to you getting this car.
A lot right now, because I'm a student, and I'm driving up to Ferris State 4 days a week right now, and my car is just kind of on its last leg here, so it's perfect timing. I'm very, very excited.
You know what's great? You're a Ferris State. My son is a Ferris Stater. Oh, right there.
There are no coincidences.
Okay,
there are
no coincidences.
Yeah. You know, I got to tell you guys, it's just so inspirational because, you know, I watch the shows, and even watching the shows, how many times have you watched it? Where, you know, you just break down with tears because you're just so happy for those people. And to know that I'm standing here with three of those people that were affected, you know, just God bless y'all, you know, just really, and just have so much fun, and I'm just happy for you.
Thank you.
Have fun. Go get in your cars. We're going to get you on film, driving out of the lot, waving goodbye into the wild blue light. Okay.
Thank you,
Kelly, Renee, Red. I appreciate it. It's 100.5 The River.